し生まれ変わったらその時はさ。
The paper whispered that you on the train like me, saying that you should unleash your pretty face like me. Oh, 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 I think there's a flaw in my code. Oh, 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 these voices won't leave me alone. Sorry, I was bored. Okay, second try. The paper whispered about you on the train like me, saying that you shouldn't waste your pretty face like me. Oh, 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 I think there's a flaw in my code. Oh, 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 these voices won't leave me alone. How is that? Okay, hello loves, welcome back to another video. This one is Nagisa. This is the series. I call it Butterfly Blues. You can find it on Wattpad. If you just type in Butterfly Blues, you'll find it. And this is the prologue. I will write a chapter every week, but for now, this is just the prologue. The prologue is actually pretty long. I don't know why I made the prologue so long. But I still hope you enjoy. So yeah, let's get into the video. I was standing in front of Kunigi Gaoka Junior High's chairman, my father, waiting for him to speak. Nerves ran down my spine as I feared that I had done something wrong. And when he gestured for me to come forward, I became even more scared. The chairman isn't only my school principal. He is also my father, and because of that, I have more to fear than just my grades slipping. I have his wrath to bear as well. My twin, Gakushu Asano, is the opposite of me. He stands up to Dad. He's unafraid of him. Though, I fear it's because Gakushu is the same as my father, and one day, may even become him. There is one difference between them, though. My brother does not make me feel like I'm worthless. I'm his sweet, beautiful younger twin sister. That is why I'll always be there to keep Gakushu from becoming our father. I'll make sure of it because I love him. Gakushu cares for me. He's always looking out for me and stands up to Dad when things have gone too far. I see when Dad puts his hands on Gakushu. It creates this urge in me, a force scarier than my father. It threatens to take over sometimes. When Gakuho hits his own son with no mercy, what kind of father does that? Our father does. Dad doesn't dare hit me, though. And no, it's not because I'm a girl. It's because I'm his prized possession. Or, as he likes to call me, his angel, princess, pumpkin, etc. Whatever he says, they all mean the same thing. And it infuriates me. Gakushu is a boy. He can have anyone he wants. He can climb to the tippy top of the economy world and become a powerful person. While I, on the other hand, am a girl. My only role in society is to social climb. Honestly, sometimes I feel like my dad would marry me off to Gakushu if it wasn't, you know, weird. Incest most likely wouldn't matter to him. He'd probably enjoy it even, creating the perfect baby. I get sick to my stomach just thinking about it. However, thankfully, Dad cares more about images than perfect, so I'll probably be married off to some rich pop star or something. I'm not even being obnoxious, that's literally something he's thought about because he's friends with the manager of a music company or something. They said it might be a good match, at least that's what I heard. I walked to my room and went to sleep right after I heard him speaking privately. Gakushu is admittedly a handsome boy. However, he isn't the only one. He might have inherited our dad's good looks and big brains, but I got mom's beautiful features, delicate and soft voice, and most importantly, her will to manipulate. For a girl or a woman, it seems like we're the ones who live our lives being controlled by our husbands and fathers, when in reality, behind the masks and in the shadows, we're the ones with the power. We control what goes on. How, one may ask, but it's fairly simple. We make men vulnerable. That's all there is to it. and it's their worst fear. To be fair though, it should be feared with how deadly a weapon it can be. Finally, my dad speaks.
Wyan, do you know what you're doing here?
I gulped. I'm still a nervous kitty around him though. Gakuho is the only one who has control over me. One day though, I hope to change that.
No sir, I do not. I respond with a confused and innocent expression.
My father smiled lightly. He looked lifeless.
I'm transferring you to class 3E.
My face dropped. Why was he doing this? I'm sure my grades were nowhere near B classes, let alone E class. So what was the reason? Gakuho seemed to read my mind as he answered my exact questions.
I'm sending you on a mission.
Oh, a mission. Now this made more sense. My usual missions were simple, but easy ones, so I assumed this one would be as well.
Need me to dig up dirt on someone? They must have a completely clean shirt if you need my help, I said, smirking.
No, no.
My father laughed off. Why was he laughing? What else could I do? Wait, did he want me to seduce someone? I've never acted out a role like that, because I've never had to, and I'm definitely not ready for something like that. I sweat dropped.
Sir? I began twiddling with my fingers.
Wyan, it's nothing hard, I promise.
He said.
I just need you to kill your teacher.
What? Kill my teacher? The words began to seep into me. As I thought about it some more, I became even more confused. Sir, what do you mean by...
Wyan, I'm going to tell you something top secret. It's a governmentally issued secret that's closed off to the public. I'm the exception, as well as Class 3E.
He waved his hand at the mention of their name. My father's attitude towards that class, Class 3E, always rubs me the wrong way. I don't understand why he has so much hate towards them. They don't do anything wrong. I mean, I know some of them can be mean, but honestly, I've seen some of the newer members around campus. They were all really nice. Besides looks, another thing my father and brother have in common is how sour they treat those below them. It hurts my heart that Gakushu feels the same way about the matter as Gakuho, but nevertheless, I'll love him and protect him no matter what.
Sir, my mission is to kill my teacher?
I broke up the last three words just so I could identify that I heard him correctly.
Yes, for you to completely comprehend the situation. I'll explain it to her.
A handsome man with black hair walked into the office. I had never seen him before. He wore a black pop-cultured suit, and compared to the other teachers at Kunigagaoka, yeah, I definitely would have remembered if he taught in any of my classes. Not that I have a wide variety of experience. I sighed.
Hello, my name is Karasuma Tadaomi.
The man bowed.
Right, my name is Asuna Wyan.
I returned the gesture and waited for him to continue speaking.
I'm going to give you a brief explanation on what is going to happen. Come your departure from the main campus.
He said. He was so cute, I could have took over 500 photos of him. No joke. I had to compose myself though, because my father was right in front of me.
You've recently seen the moon, yes?
He questioned. I nodded my head.
The thing that made it that way wants to be the new teacher of Class 3E here at Kunigigaoka.
The way he said my school's name left a bad taste in my mouth, though I couldn't complain because I've always said it that way, in my mind, of course.
Class 3E has been assigned to kill it before it blows up the world in August of this year.
Wait, what? I shouted.
Wyan, please calm down.
My father spoke as if he was trying to be normal, but I knew better. Yes, sorry, sir.
Wyan, I heard you have experience with guns?
Karasuma stated.
Wyan here is really into games. She may know how to handle a rifle better than the common assassin.
My father piped up. Oh, how he had a way of bragging. I know he brags about how smart me and Gakushu are to everyone he comes in contact with.
I mentally rolled my eyes, but stayed silent. I do. I have a fine fascination for them, I kindly replied.
I'm the assassin sent from the government, and from experience, I can tell you it will be no easy task defeating that thing. So, if you would like to decline this offer, I am happy to oblige. I will not force you into anything.
Why am I targeted? I mean, I'm nothing special. I love shooting games. Other than that, I'm a boring brick. I'm not allowed to have friends. Not that I'm complaining with the lack of equity the students here have. I'm not allowed to watch movies. I'm not allowed to listen to music. And I'm especially not allowed to have a boyfriend. Again, not complaining, but still, it's up there. Before I said anything, I looked at my father. He gave me one of his looks.
Living with Gakuho, I picked up well on how to read facial features. He said,
"Agree, Wayan."
I knew I didn't have a choice, so I did what was forced on me. I made eye contact with Mr. Karasuma again and faked a bright smile. I'd be happy to join Class 3 and help them with their assassination attempts.
Then that settles it.
My father clasped his hands together with a closed-eyed smile.
You'll start Monday, the first day of school.
Okay, I said. I made one last bow at him. Then I missed a crosswalk and walked out of his office. On my way back to 3A, I stopped and looked around the campus I'd spent my last 2 years at and what I'd spend my next 4 at. I may just never escape. I laughed out. Finally, I again found 3A. The 2A students from last year were all huddled up in that class the weekend before so we could get a jump start on this year's exams. And it was mandatory. It was rather boring since me and Gakushu knew most of what we'd be learning already. I could honestly care way less on the subject, but because of my name, Asano Yin, the Asano part particularly, I'll have to play the part of the perfect daughter. At least, for now. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed that video, everyone. Ooh, ooh, ooh. We finished. Oh my god, I have 23 minutes to edit, but that is fine. We are getting it out before 9, and that rhymed as well, because... Okay, I don't know what rhymes. Okay. But anyways, I hope you enjoyed. Bye, loves!